Hello and welcome back everyone. Let's take a look on another set of questions for JavaScript interviews. So there can be a question like, what is the difference between type of and instance of methods? So type of we use to determine the property of the primitives, like type of number, type of string, type of boolean. So like we have the type of is used to determine the type first of all. So if you have var x equal to number, then if you do type of x, then it will give you the string number. So there is a object, right? So whenever you do type of that object, then it will give you object. So the thing is, so there are different primitive types in JavaScript, which is number, string, boolean, object, and function. So whenever you do type of, it gives the answer one of them. If the variable is string, then it will give you the string. If variable is number, then type of that variable will give you the number. If you do the type of null, then it will give you the object. If you do the type of undefined, then it will give you undefined. So type of null will always be an object, type of undefined will always be undefined, and type of function is a function. Okay, type of any kind of array or object will be object. Okay, type of null will return an object. This is an important one. Okay. Another thing is instance of we use to check if the string is instance of name or not, like this. So I created the name, which is actually a string object. Then again I'm checking. So instance of can be used to check whether the newly created object is of type that or not. Similarly, I created a string and I'm using name instance of string, so it will give me true, right? Because name is an object of string. Similarly, dog instance of animal, I'm just creating a dog object from the new animal function, so obviously dog will be instance of animal. Another way is how we can calculate the properties, length of an object. So on the object we have a different methods, object.keys, object.entries, right? So similarly, using object.keys, which will give you an array, you can do a dot length on that. So it will tell you how many properties are there in the object. Another way is there is a getLength function we have written, which is where we are passing the object, where we put the count equal to 0, and we are iterating on to that object, key in object, and based on that, if object.hasOn property key, then increase the count and return the count. So what this getLength function is doing, it is returning the number of properties inside an object. Another shorthand function is object.get on property names counter, and it will give you the array, and you just do the length on that. So object.keys, which will give you an array on which you can iterate and get each and every object properties, or you can do the object dot, you can just write a foreign loop to iterate on each and every object property. Another thing is a basic question, the difference between function, methods, and constructor. So this is a object we have written, and from the object we are calling hello world function, right? So this is an object we have defined function as a property. This is the minimal function definition, and here we are calling hello world, right? Last thing is the constructor. So this is the function, everybody can write the functions. Last thing is the creating the constructor function. So here I created a function. Now using the new keyword, I'm actually creating the object of this employee function. So new actually is going to call the constructor of the employee function, and we are creating the object of the employee function. Okay. Another off topic is, what are the service worker and when can we use them? The service workers are more popular in on the browser and in the progressive web app, or the light app which we are launching on the Chrome. So service workers are some JavaScript code execution environment that runs in the background, that gives you capability to cache the files offline and read the file without the network. So it is a technology that allows your web application to use a cache resource first. So service workers are actually a mechanism using which your application will use the cached resources first. Okay, so it is actually preventing you the bad user experience while your application is offline. Okay, so it will sync locally, and then once you receive the network, it will sync the data to the network. Okay, so service workers are there, web workers are already there on the browser, which actually allows you to run something in the background while doing the interaction on the browser window. Okay, what is the difference between a method and a function in JavaScript? So this is the very basic thing. So how we declare a function, this is how we declare a function and this is how we are calling it now. So a function can take a form of immediately invoked function expression IIFE. These all are actually self-invoking functions. You don't need to call them like this. So the function is something like this. So they are actually immediately invoked. They invoke themselves. You don't need to put a call statement for them. Finally, there are other ways of writing the functions with the help of arrow functions. So you can write a plain function using function expressions or using anonymous functions. Anonymous function and function expressions are common. Here we are using FE block and then we are actually using the function expression. This is called function expression or anonymous function. So this is the function. You have assigned this function to some variable and I'm just using the arrow function, so you are seeing some different here. I am not putting the brackets and all. So this is the arrow function syntax. What is immediately invoked functions and how it can be useful? So immediately invoked function can be useful whenever you don't need to call a function. You can trigger a function directly. So here in the second code, we are able to call this myIFE function because I'm passing the argument here. Okay, IFE block is used to prevent the global scope being populated in the local scope. So if something is there in the global scope, that will not be accessible or available in the function scope of IFE block. Okay, so these are the important questions which can be asked, and these are very basics also. How to declare a function, how to create an object, what is, the constructor functions, using the function expressions, using the public functions inside an object as a property, or calculating the length or iterating on to a particular object, cloning object, shallow cloning, deep cloning, or iterating the object properties, copying the object properties. So object.hasOwn property, object.keys, object.own property names, object.freeze, object.create, object.define property. All these methods are on the object, capital O object.